Next one, if P and Q are lengths of perpendiculars from the origin to the line, x cos theta minus y sin theta is equal to k into cos 2 theta and x sec theta plus y cosec theta is equal to k respectively, we have to prove that P square plus 4 Q square is equal to k square. What are the given condition? There are two lines given. For this line, the length of the perpendicular from the origin to the line is given as P, and same way length of the perpendicular from the origin to this line is given as Q. And we have to prove P square plus 4Q square is equal to K square. K is the constant on the right side of both the equation. So what we can do is, if the line given as AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0, we have the formula to find the distance of the line from the origin, and the formula is given by modulus of C divided by root of A square plus B square. So we are going to consider the first equation, x cos theta minus y sin theta is equal to k into cos 2 theta. So here you can identify the value of A as the coefficient of x, which is cos theta, value of B as coefficient of y, which is minus sin theta, and C as a constant term, which will be equal to minus k into cos 2 theta. Why? Because C is on the left side and here it is on the right side. So A is cos theta, B is minus sin theta, and C is minus k cos theta. So I am going to find the distance from the origin to the line. Distance from origin to the line, to this line, is given by the formula modulus of, instead of C we have the value minus k cos 2 theta divided by root of, A is the coefficient of x, which is cos theta, so A square is cos square theta, plus B is the coefficient of y, which is minus sin theta and its whole square. And it is already given that P is the perpendicular distance of this line from the origin. So instead of distance of from the origin to this line, we can give the value P. P is equal to modulus of minus k cos 2 theta is modulus of k cos 2 theta. We can avoid the negative sign. And what about the denominator? Denominator is cos square theta plus sin square theta. Cos square theta plus sin square theta gives you 1, and root of 1 will give you the value 1 itself. So P is modulus of k cos 2 theta. Okay, same way, distance from, we are going to take the next line. The next line given is x into sec theta plus y into cosec theta is equal to k. So there the distance is given as q. Distance from the origin to the line is given as q. And if you apply the same formula, what we can write the formula is modulus of c by root of a square plus b square. So here modulus of c means a constant term, so it is minus k divided by root of a square is the coefficient of x square, which is sec square theta plus, a square is the coefficient of x, the square of the coefficient of x, square of coefficient of x is sec square theta, and b is the coefficient of y, which is cosec theta, b square will be cosec square theta. Okay, so what we are getting, sec square theta plus cosec square theta, if I am changing it into the in terms of sine and cos, instead of cos square theta, I can write the value 1 by cos. Instead of sec square theta, I can write the value 1 by cos square theta, and instead of cosec square theta, I can write the value 1 by sin square theta. This is equal to modulus of k divided by root of, if I take the LCM inside the square root, 1 into sin square theta is sin square theta plus 1 into cos square theta is cos square theta divided by sin square theta cos square theta. So that is equal to, if I take the denominator, denominator itself is a fraction, so if I take the conjugate and multiply, what I get is modulus of k into root of sin square theta into cos square theta divided by sin square theta plus cos square theta gives you the value 1, so root 1. Okay, so this value gives you modulus of k into root of sin square theta is sin theta and root of cos square theta is cos theta. So we are getting the value of q like this. Again, go to the question. What is the question? We have to prove P square plus 4Q square equal to K square. So we will take the LHS P square plus 4Q square. What is P? P is modulus of k cos 2 theta. So P square will be k square cos square 2 theta. Isn't it? K square into cos square 2 theta plus 4 into what is Q? Q is modulus of k into sin theta cos theta. So Q square will be k square into sin square theta cos square theta. So from these two terms I can take k square outside and this term remains the same, cos square 2 theta. Instead of 4 I can write as 2 square, so I can write as 2. Instead of sin theta, sin square theta, I am writing sin theta the whole square. Same way, instead of cos square theta, I am writing cos theta the whole square. So instead of 4 sin square theta cos square theta, I am going to write it as 2 sin theta cos theta the whole square. And what is 2 sin theta cos theta? It is sin 2 theta. So this is equal to k square into cos square 2 theta plus sin square 2 theta. 2 sin theta cos theta is sin 2 theta. 2 sin theta cos theta is sin 2 theta. So we are getting sin 2 theta the whole square. So that is k square into cos square 2 theta plus sin square 2 theta. And the bracketed term is of the form sin square theta plus cos square theta. Whatever be the value of theta, sin square plus cos square gives you the value 1. So we are getting k square into 1, which gives you the value k square. So thus we are getting P square plus 4 Q square is equal to K square. Hence we proved.